Not only did the S&P 500 make history last week, it also broke out to all-time highs. Tune into the rest of our video to find out what our thoughts are on the markets for the rest of the year.
All of the major U.S. indices were positive last week, with the Russell 2000 leading the way up almost 2%. The NASDAQ still leading the way for the year up over 15%, and the S&P had a really strong week up 0.8% and now is up over 7.5% for the year, and as Matt mentioned, just made all-time highs. Foreign stocks and emerging markets were both positive last week, with foreign up about 1.5% and emerging up almost 3%. Now, although there was a strong week in foreign and emerging markets, they're both still negative for the year, with emerging down about 7% and the foreign market stocks down over 2%. The chart that we're looking at this week is of the S&P 500. Now, 2 weeks ago, I talked about the S&P 500 potentially forming a double top formation, and if this was confirmed and actually happened, it could have been a bearish signal for the S&P 500 for the remainder of the year. But instead, what we saw was a rebound in the S&P 500 last week, and the S&P 500 actually broke out to all-time highs above the top blue line on the chart at 2870. Now, what are our thoughts and what does that mean for the rest of the year? That top blue line on the chart now turns into a support level, which means we don't want to see the performance of the S&P 500 go back down below that top blue line at 2870. If the S&P 500 stays above that 2870 level, that could mean good things for the U.S. market for the rest of the year, and in that case, we would remain bullish on the S&P 500.
Last week's news kicked off with Jerome Powell giving a speech in Jackson Hole, and he shed light on the Federal Reserve and what they're looking at in regards to targets for inflation and also short-term interest rates. Right now, inflation is sitting at 2%, which is exactly where they were hoping to see it. And they're not worried too much about the economy overheating, so the plan to keep short-term interest rates raising steadily over the next year is still intact. Also over the weekend, the United States and Mexico have agreed to a NAFTA deal. With this deal in place, we're hoping that translates over to Canada coming back to the negotiating table and getting a deal done, which we've been waiting for over a year. Lastly, Brazilian markets are in turmoil over the latest presidential polls. These polls are showing former President Lula leading the way. And President Lula is currently sitting in jail on corruption charges. So the fear is that the Workers' Party is going to come back to power. And the emerging markets have already had a pretty bad year so far. And this news will definitely not help. We're starting to see some political uncertainty creep into the news. This, along with midterm elections coming up shortly, could be a cause for concern.
Hopefully, the U.S. markets can shrug off these concerns, just like it has foreign and emerging markets sell off this year.
Thanks for watching, and we strive to give you everything that you need to know about the markets in 5 minutes or less.
Like our Facebook page and share our video. Thanks a lot.